Welcome back to Corridors of Power with Mr. J.K. Tripathi, Commissioner of Police of Greater Chennai. Sir, also, we've seen reports about your surprise visits at police stations. Sometimes you go in mufti and they are unable to recognize you sometimes. What is the reaction when you go there initially? I know at one place, I think in Marina Police Station sometime back, soon after you took over, the sentry didn't recognize you, and then of course you were asked to see the inspector. Why do you do this, and what is the reaction when you go there?
No, the purpose of these incognito visits are primarily to see how my boys are working in the police station, how is the response to the public, somebody comes with a grievance, how do they receive him, and how they deal with it. And
it used to happen a lot during the Mughal period, where the kings used to go in disguise and...
Well, it's not exactly that type of disguise, I just go in CVs.
Okay.
And it's true that, you know, few
you
places.
Sometimes ensure that your car also parked away and then you walk down there.
I do, yeah. I do walk a distance to reach the place. And I have mixed feelings whenever I've gone there. And to tell you honestly, I have not found any serious violations or misbehavior in any police station I visited.
Mm-hmm.
So I do go and stand in a particular place for some time, watch what exactly is happening. And then I do go myself seeking any help there.
Mm.
Many places without knowing, also people have come forward voluntarily. They supported me as a victim.
Mm.
And a few places they have been indifferent. Few places they have asked me to wait for the officers to come.
Okay.
So I get a direct first-hand impression.
Have you ever tried telling them, I will tell the commissioner if you don't call the officer?
No. But I have heard them telling me.
Okay.
When I offered bribe to a particular constable.
Uh-huh.
So he told that if you do that, you will go to jail.
Mm.
My commissioner is very strict.
Okay.
So then that
message has gone down.
So that I really gave me a lot of pleasure that yes, I want each of them to be like that.
Mm.
And another thing that I wanted to primarily see is that when somebody goes to the police station, whether his complaint is immediately received, or do they ask them to wait for the officers to come. So when I get such first-hand impression myself, it helps me to brief my officers, telling them that these are the things which are not going all right. So better set your house in order.
Hmm, so you're completely a hands-on commissioner that way.
Absolutely, first-hand. This is very, very, very useful for me when I see it for myself.
Hmm.
I also go and stand in some traffic junctions and see how the traffic flows.
Hmm.
Whenever I get a complaint about a particular place from where there are somebody you know, sends a mail or somebody calls me or sends SMS that the traffic personnel are demanding money, so I go and stand there to see myself. I have tried myself. Bribing somebody by after committing a violation.
Mm.
So you understand that what exactly happens at this spot, and where people behave well and where.
Is that the reason why you've also, like, for instance, you've introduced e-challans now?
Yes, e-challan has lot of advantages. One is that it has the scope of using your cards.
Credit cards. Then.
Yes. So the cash, the flow of cash is not there.
Mm.
And of course, if you are supposed to be paying through your credit card, so you don't have to offer anybody any bribe.
There's a record also of
it's
that.
It's a record and you get a receipt of it.
Okay.
Another thing which helps us is to have access to our database in which we find whether you have already come to any address notice earlier.
Mm.
So we know that, okay, you are a repeat.
Repeat offender, and you can even proceed to cancel license or suspend the license.
That is coming at the next stage.
Coming up. Also, it's an age-old complaint, sir, that, not just in Chennai but across the country, where complainants are tossed around citing jurisdiction. That, we are told, happens even today.
Yeah.
What is being done now to ensure that this doesn't, so that an innocent person or a victim of a crime goes to a police station, even if he goes to the nearest police station, which may not be in his jurisdiction, that the complaint that he's entertained in the complaint registered?
In fact, what I find myself is that such complaints are on the fall. They are coming down. And when we come across any such complaint, we take very strong action against the person who has tried to toss it around.
Mm-hmm.
So, one is that by educating my own people. Number two is by taking exemplary action against somebody who has done this. What happens exactly is that we still do not have a system in place where we can reduce the workload, the scriptory workload in a police station.
Mm-hmm.
So in a urban scenario, if somebody tells you that, okay, if you maybe go another 3 kilometers, you go to the proper jurisdiction, I think it can be taken in that spirit. But otherwise what happens is that in that particular police station they receive the complaint and then it takes some time for them to forward it.
Mm-hmm.
We have to have a proper networking in place where the citizens can lodge complaint at any terminal and it is forwarded by us to the jurisdiction police station.
Okay.
But it is always advantageous for the complainant as well as the investigating officer to have a one-to-one discussion.
Okay.
When you prefer a complaint, it gives a lot of insight into the complaint.
Okay.
Rather than seeing it at an impersonal level, something is forwarded to you read through it.
Okay.
So, that day will come when maybe this also will work to the same standard as we expect. But the investigation can be really more meaningful when the investigating officer interacts with the complainant while going through the complaint itself, try to elicit some more points and look through it about the different angularities in a complaint.
So most people say that, you know, the biggest advantage with the AIADMK government is that there's no interference in policing. Have you faced any interference in policing so far?
Absolutely not.
Okay.
I think it was made very, very clear by the Honorable Chief Minister herself in the Assembly. We have been asked clearly that our loyalty is to the law, to the Constitution. So I do not experience any pressure or any interference from any quarters.
And also the choice of the team. I mean, many say that. Not to flatter you, but they say that they couldn't have got a better commissioner this time, somebody who believes in enforcing the law without fear or favour. And also the team that you've rustled up, you've got a fairly young team, pretty young officers. One of them, in fact, Ashwin Kutnis, many say looks like your younger brother. Young team in place.
Young team has lot of advantages. It has got little bit of disadvantage also, but then I look at it in this way, that if the boys are absolutely professionally competent and we have to bring in professional policing in Chennai city, nobody else can deliver better than this young team that we have. And there are a lot of expectations from them. They have spent about 100 days now. And I am very sure that they will live up to the expectations of the citizens they are serving.
Talking of a young team also, but youngsters. And one grievance that youngsters in the city have, especially the party goers, is that this 11 o'clock Cinderella hour is still not been relaxed. In fact, there are people who go to pubs who say that by 10:30, the pub owners get restless. They say the police may come anytime. So quickly, there are people who work in IT companies on shifts who perhaps go, the only time that they get is after 10:30 in the night to unwind. And they feel that the police is playing killjoy in this case.
No.
You've taken an anti-party stand, not against the political party, but against the party goers.
No, we are not goofers. We are not party goofers. Actually, to tell you honestly, we are only enforcing the rule. We have to enforce the rule, and we are not as bad as some other parts of the country where there are other restrictions too. But then we have to enforce the rule of the land, and that is what we are doing.
So again, we are talking about the e-challans, also the e-beat system. The old good old patta book today is being replaced by an e-beat system where a police constable or whoever is on the beat patrol cannot actually fudge records. He has to be physically present there because there's an entry made. He cannot just sign there later on, like proxy attendance that you have in colleges these days.
No, I trust my boys that they will not, it's not meant basically to check on that. More so because, somebody is holding a patta book. And you have to go at odd hours and disturb the person. Primarily, it is harassment to the citizen who is holding the patta book. So that is why we have changed over to this. And here what happens is that we ensure the presence of the beat officer at the particular point, which is recorded electronically. At the same time, there is no hardship or disturbance to the citizen who is holding the patta book.
Okay.
Yeah.
Also, there are certain crime zones, the black spots as you call them. I know the police has been trying to address the problems from various angles, including at a social, socio-economic level. Like for instance, this massive, which is called something that's called perhaps the biggest ever slum resettlement colony in Asia, tsunami resettlement colony in Kannaginagar. How much of a threat does Kannagi Naga pose to adjoining areas or to the rest of the city, sir?
We have both the things in place. One is that lot of proactive measures for their rehabilitation, massive scale, that we are already into that, so that we help the youngsters, the people who are jobless, who have not really studied much. So we are trying to empower them and to make them employable, either self-employment or they get some job somewhere, because there are a lot of demand for the drivers, the mechanics, the plumbers, in any field that you see. So we are into that. At the same time, there is a check on those characters who have the tendency still to go towards delinquency.
But there is a real danger here, because you have a lot of residential complexes coming up in the vicinity, and you have these people here, this massive colony there. Now, when you source, for instance, domestic help from these places, how safe is it? Because how many people really today use the police service of verifying antecedents before they employ people?
We see, the thing is, we do appeal, and we are sure that all the citizens will make use of this system, that, you know, we are offering our services to verify the domestic helps. They will do that. It is already, I can see the response improving.
Hmm. There are a lot of agencies actually which run...
We are asking the agencies themselves to write to us.
Okay.
Before they send somebody, before they depute somebody to a household. We are asking that they let the agencies themselves refer the cases to us.
Hmm.
We verify them, whether in our state or outside the state. We are.
But many agencies today don't have basic records, like even ration cards or...
They do not have, and we will be insisting on that.
Okay.
It needs to be streamlined.
Mm-hmm.
But I tell you another thing is that this target group of Kannagi Naga, the residential colonies coming up around the place, it is all economic interdependence between the both.
Mm.
And we have a police station there. We will definitely ensure that the people who are going and working in those households, they behave.
Okay.
We will have a monitoring system. They will already have the cameras in place.
Mm-hmm.
And we also know who is living where they are working. They are absolutely under close surveillance.
Okay.
So people should not have any apprehension in mind that they should not employ these people.
Mm.
Where else they will go?
Mm.
They depend on these people only.
Correct.
Then they will be forced to go to crimes.
Mm. Also, unsolved cases. Tamanna case which hit the headlines, and you know, thanks to the efforts of the police, you managed to rescue her and reunite her with her parents. We saw a very poignant picture of you, in fact, the little girl planting a kiss on your cheek and you responding immediately. What happened to Tamanna's things? Who actually took her and went?
We already have two such groups in our scanner.
Mm-hmm.
And investigation is going on quietly, because I don't want them to run away.
Mm-hmm.
I am confident that we will get out the person who did this.
Mm-hmm.
We have already cracked the other two cases.
I see.
And of course, we do not find any direct linkages, but our investigation is going absolutely on correct lines, and we will solve that case.
Mm. Two final questions. So one is, of course, the people-friendly measures in continuation of that. Today, when the Chief Minister's convoy passes, we don't find traffic being blocked. Was that a direct order from the Chief Minister to ensure that it's not blocked?
Of course.
No traffic has stopped. In fact, you find that the United States, that the President's convoy passes and the common people also go along the same way.
Absolutely. That is the orders are very clear. That is, let there be no inconvenience to the people at all, in any form.
Mm.
So we are enforcing that.
Challenging for you, because you have to also keep in mind the PVIP security here.
We do. We do not compromise on the security aspects in any way.
Mm.
And at the same time, you know, of course, there is a little risk involved in it, but then we are equal to the task.
Facebook. Are you on Facebook, sir? A lot of officers are on Facebook.
I wish I had the time, but right now our...
Your traffic police is active on Facebook.
Traffic is active on the Facebook. It's a wing of mine. And we have just, you know, about a month old. And I am very happy about the response.
Mm.
And once we ourselves are settled fully, we are confident of handling the queries, handling the Facebook properly, then we gradually extend to the other areas too.
There is a problem there, sir, because Facebook, a lot of people, it's a good initiative where you get updates. If you register through SMS, you get updates from the traffic police about traffic diversion in the city. But a precondition for that is that you should not be on the do not call registry. So how do you actually then do that? Because if you deactivate your do not call, do not disturb thing, your telemarketers will flood you with messages. And you will, if you don't deactivate it, you don't get the messages from the police. Is there any way of trying to dovetail both?
I think we are at it, and then we'll find out a solution very shortly.
Okay.
Yes.
Final question to you. How many hours do you get of sleep? I mean, you have about 150 to 200 visitors a day. Your phone doesn't stop ringing, which is why many journalists, we've decided not to actually call you, but SMS you, so that, you know, the commissioner is not disturbed by calls from the press as well.
No, I am paid to be disturbed, and I am paid to receive calls and meet the grievances of the people. But, 4 to 5 hours is enough.
4 to 5 hours of sleep?
Yeah, enough.
Thank you very much, sir, for your time, despite
nice
your hectic schedule.
Not at all.
Absolutely a pleasure to have you, and more strength to you
Me
and
too.
Your team to serve Chennai.
Thank you
very
much.
Much, sir.
Thank you,
sir.
Thank you.
Thanks.